السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. On behalf of Markaz Sahaba, the voice of Ahlus Sunnah wal Jama'ah, we present to you lesson number 1869 of our daily Nasiha and advice. Today, with the grace and mercy of Almighty Allah Jalla Wala, we focus on the fourth of Jumad al-Ukhra. It was on the 4th of Jumad al-Ukhra, the year 950 after Hijrah, corresponding to the 4th of September 1543. The Ottoman army under the command of Suleiman the Magnificent, he was known as Suleiman Qanuni, because remember that he drafted so many laws and introduced so many laws as well, and he ruled the empire for a long period. He reclaimed the fort of The name is Astulana in Belgrade, a strategic fort after engaging in fighting for 15 days with the Germans. Now let us just see three things here. Number one is this: when we study our Islamic Muslim history, Mustafa Habibuna sallallahu alaihi wasallam's demise takes place in the 11th year of the Hijrah. Thereafter we have the Khulafa'i Rashidin for 30 years. Then we have the Umayyad dynasty plus minus 90 years, 14 Khulafa. And thereafter we have the Abbasid Khilafat and dynasty. They rule for 525 years plus minus. And then we have the Ottoman Empire for 620 years. So remember that they had 37 Khulafa, the Ottoman Empire, and those people, the Abbasids. And the Umayyads had 14 Khulafa. In this day and this age, who will go and defeat the Germans? Who will be the one to lay siege against their forts and so forth? Not one Muslim country, not one Arab country. Why? We have deviated so far, far away from the deen of Islam. Remember, the true Muslim, his first focus will be on Almighty Allah Jalla Wala, Musabbibul Asbab, the one who created the entire universe and cosmos. Then you come to Asbab, then you come to the means. Therefore we say, Hasbunallahu wa ni'mal wakeel. Whenever we encounter difficulty, Hasbunallah, Allah is sufficient for us, wa ni'mal wakeel, and Allah is the best dispenser of the matters and affairs. Then Edward, this is Surah 3, chapter 3, Surah Al-Imran, verse 173. And Edward that, Surah chapter 22, verse 78. Fa ni'mal mawla wa ni'mal nasir. And Almighty Allah is the best protector, and Almighty Allah Jalla Wala is the best of helper. So that is the biggest lesson we have to learn, quwwat-e imani, or the power of our iman, our strength, our faith, our conviction. Almighty Allah never addresses us, Ya ayyuhalladhina aslamu, O you Muslims, no. Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu, O iman walo, O you who believe, 89 different places, Almighty Allah Jalla Wala addresses us, because iman is the motivating force. Iman makes that person go out in jihad. Iman wakes that person up for tahajjud. Iman makes that person give charity. Iman is the one that motivates and inspires us, male, female, adult and children. So this is what they had, the Ottoman Empire. May Almighty Allah Jalla Wala return the Khilafat back to this Ummah, and all this duwailat, all these klein states we have. In English you call them klein states, that they are ruled by the Americans, by the Europeans, and so forth. There's not one Muslim country, Arab country, that has a veto. All that is in the hands of the kuffar and the non-Muslims. So obviously, so what good are we? So we have to take directives from them. That's a shame and a disgrace. So may Almighty Allah give us that tawfiq, that we know who we are aligned to. We may have allegiance with Almighty Allah Jalla Wala, but Mustafa Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, Deenul Islam, everything else is secondary. La ta'ata li makhlukin fi ma'siyatil khaliq. There is no obedience to any creation when it leads to a sin against the Creator. May Almighty Allah give us a true understanding of Deenul Islam. Ameen. The hadith in Mishkat Sharif. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.